restaurant called Nick and Nat's Uptown 21 has opened up here in Waterloo, and it is a labor of love for this couple who share a passion for good food. So Natalie, tell me a little bit about this location.
We've been sort of thinking about opening our restaurant for a long time, and you know, Uptown Waterloo seemed like the perfect location. It's a very healthy market. There's lots of great restaurants in the city. And so we wanted to be part of that, part of the great restaurants. And when this location came available, we didn't stop to think. We were, you know, let's do it. And even though I was pregnant at the time, and you know, we couldn't let that stop us. So we were lucky enough that we were able to get into the space, and we worked really hard to open it.
Natalie, tell me about your background in this industry. You know, you've come a long way. This is exciting. Yeah. How did this happen?
It's probably been about 12 years. Nick and I have known each other for that long. We met at a local restaurant in Kitchener, La Costa, as some of you might know. And ever since we met, we just sort of knew we wanted to open a restaurant one day. And we're glad we waited this long because it gave us lots of experience and a lot of time to sort of figure out exactly what we wanted to do for people and what type of restaurant we wanted to do.
People love a good love story. Tell us how you two met.
Well, we met at La Costa in Kitchener, and Nick was the prep cook at the time, and I started serving there. And we worked together for about 4 months there. Then he moved to Hamilton, and then I moved to follow him, type of thing. So we've always been, you know, working side by side.
Now the two of you work so well together. I've seen it for myself. What makes you complement each other so well?
I think we both have the same passion for good quality product and service, and I think we're both a little bit of a perfectionist in that sense. You know, I like to do things in a certain way, and so does he, but you know, we complement in that he's back of the house, I'm front of the house, so we balance each other out.
How do you find that the local food scene from field to table influences your menu?
That's sort of what inspired us, was the local food. You know, Nick has been involved with local farmers for the past 7 years, I think, you know, like really trying to, you know, demonstrate what great products we have in the area. So the menu is very much inspired by what we offer here.
For somebody walking in here for the first time, what can they expect?
Well, they can expect great quality food at a reasonable price. That's the whole idea of the prefix menu, is just to keep the cost down by having a limited menu. The same way with our wine list, we also keep a very limited wine list to keep our inventory a little bit smaller. So they're gonna get great service, great food at a very reasonable price, you know, in a fine dining establishment.
The mastermind behind the menu here at Uptown 21 is Chef Nick Benninger, and I'm so excited to be back here because it's always fun to be privy to the, you know, the behind the scenes scoop. So Nick, tell us a little bit about your inspiration behind the menu that you have currently right now, because this is your first menu.
Yeah.
And you compared it to music, where this is your first album and you've got different types of songs on there. There's ballads.
Yeah, just in the sense of I think a person's first album or their first work put forward is sort of a culmination of their life's work, whereas the next one maybe is put together in a year and a half, but this was a long time coming, so to speak. So all these dishes are things that I maybe loved 10 years ago, and I've just been refining them since then and sort of all come together now. So.
And what are you going to be showing us today?
Today I'm going to show you just a crepe dish. This was an item off of our prefix menu last night. We have an everyday changing prefix menu that offers 3 or 4 courses for the guests, and we just change it on a daily basis, so it keeps the ideas fresh, it keeps us fresh, and it gives our regulars a chance to always know that they're not stuck in a rut here, like they can move on to new dishes every day.
So. Excellent, so show us the way.
Great, so what I'm making is just these nice crepes, which I've prepared earlier. I'm gonna fill them with a little bit of honey mushrooms, a little bit of wilted frisée, a little bit of cauliflower as well. I'm going to start the pan off with just a little bit of this herb and almond butter that I made up ahead of time. I've got these really nice honey mushrooms. These mushrooms have a sort of a delicate flavor, but a really nice texture. So a little bit of salt and pepper. These are some nice savory crepes that we made. They've got a little bit of sage and a little bit of caramelized garlic inside of them. So I'm throwing a little bit of cauliflower in here. Cauliflower is going to give it a nice, almost like a foil to the earthiness of the mushrooms and the almonds. There's just going to be a nice, again, some nice texture. Cauliflower kind of never loses its crunch. And just that layers of earthiness. So I'm going to throw in a little blonde frisée, which is one of my favorite things. Because again, it's a lettuce that can take a little bit of heat. It's got a nice bitterness to it.
It wilts really well.
Yeah, it wilts really nicely. So a little bit of white wine, just to help bring things together. And then a secret passion of mine is truffle oil. Anytime I'm cooking with mushrooms, I'll add a drop or two to it. But it's just gonna help elevate that mushroom flavor a little bit further. And you can smell it. Now I've got this foie gras torchon that we make. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna take a few slices of it and put it on top.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited to try this. This to me is a delicious love story. Since the day that Nick met his wife, Natalie, they have aspired to open up a restaurant, and now they've done it and waiting over a decade to do it right. So, Uptown 21 here in Waterloo, check it out. Oh, can't wait to try this.